Hello and welcome back to another one of my BeamNG.drive videos. Today I'm on Tough Truck Map and I'm going to do a little bit of driving on it. So I'm in my custom made pickup with a 7-litre V8 engine in it, so it's got more than enough power to do what we need it to do today. Obviously it's been raised on off road tyres, so we're going to go ahead and just do this right here for quickly. Let me see how well it does this. So it should do it pretty good. I've done it really well. I handled it reasonably well. A bit about the beginning there, nothing too bad. And this gets a bit more interesting as each side is sloped higher than another end, if you know what I mean. A bit hard to explain, I can't really think of the technical term for it. Got another engine sound in there for a minute. What I'm going to do, quickly going to go into this truck here. Just to get rid of the sound off the engine at the minute. Gonna remove that quickly. And we'll go back to that in a minute. Didn't realise I still had that in the game. I wanna go nice and slow from there. I don't have a snorkel on here, so we'll start to drown it a bit easily, but yeah, it still got through pretty easily. And it's making this quite well. Quite a nice map. Put the trucks through a bit of a challenge. It's really not too hard of a challenge, really. As you're only driving over a few bumps, I mean, a bit over and then the right, that would probably be the hardest part, I'd imagine. Obviously, you need quite a good ground clearance for most of it. Nothing over there. Actually, so now that's all completed, we're going to go down here. And we're going to go over here. Now, I assume we start on this side. So we're going to go over here. I'm probably wrong, but it doesn't. I don't think it matters anyway, so. Or we could go over it this way instead. Quite a tough map, but the truck should do it. Obviously the axle suck now, and if it will go into reverse, I'm holding down the backwards arrow, but nothing was happening, and again holding forward, and we suck. We are actually stuck. Come on, reverse! Thank you! And we've made it that time, which is good. Over some logs, which it should do fine. Not much damage to the truck. The bonnet's popped open a little bit, but yeah, nothing too much. Now the hardest part, I think, would be these. Concrete, what look like sewage pipes, or even water. Definitely used for some sort of water. We have a popped tyre. But we should still be able to do it. I'm still going to do it with the truck. Should do it fine. I've still got 3 good wheels. That's all you need. And there we go. Pretty much done that part. Hopped over the water in there and we're finished. So we're going to go this way over here. We're not going to go up that way. We're going to come down that way in a minute. Hop over these. Again, it should do these quite easily. After any mounds, got a bit more damage to the front of the car now. Hop over this one as well. I'm not really being careful, as you can see, just speeding over them. Obviously, you realise you'd be a bit more careful going over them, but I'm not really going to be bothered. Be bothered about being too careful. Alright, so we're now coming down here. And what we're going to do, we're going to insert the vehicle here so it resets it, gives it more health. Actually, we'll be coming back here in a minute. So now we're going to go up and do this course here. It shouldn't be too hard to do this, isn't it? Get over this little bit here, And we've just about made it over. This is good. Well, you have done this course really, and it is quite fun to do. Especially in different vehicles. I mean, I prefer doing it in this. I like driving this vehicle. The way I've modified it as well with the engine and all that. It's quite a nice package. Going up the hill here and down here. I will try doing this course in a minute with that truck you saw. So I will spawn it back in again in a minute. And that was the ETK mod. Ooh, that's a bit of damage on the front. But this truck's powering through and we're now gonna drop down. This is one reason I'm doing this around. But yeah, again, I don't think it matters which way you do it around, really. Oop, a broken axle. Broken axle, snap us out of the game. Get my truck to be first. There we go, about time. I go forward. And again, it'll take about a year and a half to be first. There we go. Come on, truck. Come on. Come on. There we go. Come on. It's at the top. Three-wheel drive isn't that good, apparently. Apparently three-wheel drive isn't good for off-roading. And all of this gearbox either. Okay, apparently no wheels, or one wheel spinning. Apparently we're not going anywhere. I'm gonna give it a little nudge, see if we can unstick it. I think we're stuck for some reason. It seems to be trying to move now. There we go. With a little bit of help, we managed to get over. So we're going to continue on our way. And we hit something. There. What are we hitting on? Is it nuts? Oh, there we go. We've got over it anyway. That doesn't look nice. Don't bend on me, wheel. I don't think that wheel doesn't look too healthy. I'm not going straight again now. I'm going to let the cool down for a minute. We don't want to overheat and ruin the car. That sounds about right, or looks about right. Give it enough attempt to get over here. There we go, we're over. I don't want to let the car overheat at the minute. I still have quite a long way to go as of yet. There we go, we're down the hill now. And we're going to continue over in this part here. Made it over perfectly. There we go. Nice little pond. Not really pond. But a puddle. Still going pretty good on three-wheel drive. We've got a little suck, but I'm not sure if that's the game or just a vehicle or whatever, so I don't know if to count that or not. Either way, I'm pretending this vehicle has a winch on it. So we winched ourselves out. Which a vehicle like this in real life, you have a winch. For tricky situations like this. Oh, we lost a bumper. Not too worried, we'll go to the shop and get back and get a new one. Around the corner, into another puddle. Getting quite bouncy along here. Oh, and we broke another axle somehow. So we're now on two-wheel drive. soon go along in two-wheel drive pretty easily. Although, I think when we get into the more tricky situations, I don't think this truck's gonna do very well. But we'll soon see. Come on, truck. I know you're struggling in a bit, but there's no reason to not complete the course. Around the corner again, through more mud. We're doing pretty well. Obviously we got stuck a little bit. And we're now on two-wheel drive. And lost a bumper and a broken window. We can't afford to do that car, not two-wheel drive. See, that's the problem. Now we're on two-wheel drive, we're getting stuck a bit more now. If we didn't hit that rock thing, I think we would have made that. But again, it's really bad. We hold down to go forward and nothing happens. Same in reverse. You have to wait for about a year and a half to actually move in either direction when you want to. And we're going to slide up again by looking at trying to unflip without having to cheat a little, but I think we're going to have to. And we're going to push it on. That didn't. What's the point of that then? Obviously, I'm not gonna help. Let's try that again. Power, power. Put the power down, come on. Oh, we hit the rock again and it bounced us. Come on. Come on, my two-wheel drive car. Come on. Come on, find a grip. Find a grip. Nope. I'm gonna overheat again. I'm gonna roll it back down the hill again. And we're gonna give it some more welly. Right, come on, let's go. Let's go, let's go. And we hit. We got a Punisher, but we made it. Come on. Come on. Yes, we made it. And it's flipped again, so we're gonna get out the car, we're gonna push it over. And so we're now kind of pretty much a one wheel drive. Near enough, you could see. And I don't think it's gonna do that. Not with one good tyre. But I'm gonna do it. I'm determined. Gonna make it. Come on this way. Right, I'm gonna cheat a little. I'm gonna get the old winch out again. Right, let's get the winch out and we're gonna winch up the hill. If I can even see where I'm going, might be better if I use that angle instead. Come on. Oh, pressed the wrong button again. Come on. Accidentally clicked off the game. So it let go of the green dot. Can I? What's going on? Why does it keep clicking off the game? Right. We made it with the help of the winch again. Continue. Oh, and I got a broken radiator as well. Come on, car. You can do it. Oh, we would have done it if we didn't turn on us like that. Stop turning on us. Your drive shaft is broken. That's it. Nothing else. Oh, we've made it just about up there as well. Now to get down to it. Hopefully, I think we should start going down now. Yeah, there we go, we're nearly there. And we have to break locks down here. I am pressing the brake pedal as far as fingerly possible. And we made it. Just. Last time I made it properly down without breaking any tires or drive shafts. But I should still count that as making it. And this wounded and battered car made it down the hill. And then you got to bear in mind, I had one popped tire, so it wasn't going to brake as effectively as it should have. But this battered car with one working tire, pretty much, one is not really in there. Two wheel drive, but then technically, like I said, it's one wheel drive as it had a popped tire or puncture tire, whatever you want to say, and it still made it. And it's still driving. Really fine. I don't think we'll do it again, not in this current state, but we'll do a little burnout victory. Have we done it? We'll go back to it in a minute with another truck. Let's see what's down here first. Head gas it's damaged. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me how badly damaged this truck is. We suck. Yep, one more drive's not going to help us out. So we're going to pull it off. There we go. We're going to turn it around. And eventually the gearbox wakes up to go forward. Well, I finished the gearbox, probably did the game doing that. Just about made it up. And if we look over here, it still makes how this truck pick up. You probably say pick up. It's still going. Quick, before it dies, I'm gonna pull it on. And we made it. There we go, look at this. We made it across. Winched ourselves over. Just in time for the engine to die. Into a small ditch, kind of. And that truck did pretty well. We're gonna reset it. And we're gonna go into vehicles. And we're gonna now drive it with a big ETK. Off these models, not an actual official release. So we're going to go into the wooden carrier and we're going to replace the current. Now I'm going to slightly modify this truck a little bit so it can do it a bit better. I modified it last time and it made it fine. Got stuck a little bit, but I managed to get free without using that little clicky thing to pull it. It actually freed itself. And then one other thing I'll do, apart from that, I'm going to go into the front bumper. I'm going to get rid of the bumper. If it's one specific place where no bumper would be better. So let's try this. And we flip already. I didn't do that last time, so I'm going to reset it. And try again. There we go, made through that flipping this side. This is a little bit stuck locked on a little. And it's making it, is it? Come on, truck. Come on, you know you wanna. It's not really the truck first, in fact, it's not got particularly enough ground clearance to do this type of thing. As you can see, it's beaching itself in there. I did do it last time, just about. Find the grip. If it finds the grip, it should do it. Come on. There we go. Are we doing it? I did cheat a bit. I did go around a little bit. I'm still counting it. I'm counting that as SA66. Now we're gonna go the same route again, let's see, in this truck. This truck looks just at the hole doing this. We lost a fuel tank. I didn't do that last time. That's something different. But we don't need it. We've got three other ones. Or should I say two other ones. So we've still got enough fuel to do this. Powered up there. Easily. But in this, next to the top area, this truck would actually be being driven in real life. You know, for muddy tracks. Going where it need to go to deliver the people in the back, or the soldiers in the back. Come on, up the hill. Come on. I mean, I could put this into full on manual mode, but I'm going to let the gearbox try its own thing for a change. It worked last time without me having to interrupt, so hopefully it will do the same this time. There we go, to find the right areas. To get ripped, and now here we go again, back down this hill. And again down. This is where we got stuck last time. That's why I took the bumper off, but without the bumper, it will get up a bit better, hopefully. I did make it up last time with the bumper on, but it took a bit more ramming to get me over the sea. Come on.
Yeah.
There we go. Just. Yeah, last time I got stuck in there, so I took before taking the bumper off. Help us settle the course a little bit better without getting stuck as much. Which has paid off. Up here. This is where we got stuck as well last time. But we made it first time this time, which is good. Over the bumps here. But you could easily leave this truck here and it blending a bit easier, you know. Nice. It'd be nice to get this room eventually to have this game multiplayer. So you know, many more people driving these trucks along the same tracks would be quite nice video. You could do that. There's like three or four of these behind. Nice sort of convoy of army trucks. Going back through this little track we've obviously seen before. I've always wanted a map like this. A nice little trail so I can drive this track along. Finally, a map has been released like this where I can drive along a nice dirt track where you get bogged in this truck. I really like this track. It handles pretty well for the power and off the 6-wheel drive. It doesn't get stuck that easily. I will be playing on this map quite a lot really, playing along in this little mud tracks. Shame it's not more, really. I would like a bit more of these tracks. Especially one where you can take this truck with your trailer on it, pull it through. But this is still pretty decent. And now we're on the final stretch of this mud patch again. Go up the steep hill. Hopefully this should do better than our two-wheel drive car which we had. More pickup would probably be the best word, I think. Anyway, come on truck, you can do it. There we go, we made it. Feel that patch there. Come on your own. Come on, can interrupt. Can you do it? Come on, truck. Come on. Find the grip. Find the grip. Come on, you can do it, truck. Right, we're gonna give it enough a little run up. See, look how nice this truck looks in this area, look. Nice and hidden. There you go, look at that. I can barely see the truck now. Like a world of camouflage works. See, look. I can barely see it, look at that. That camouflage is brilliant. You wouldn't know there's a truck here. Looking at that, you would not know there's a truck right here. Alright, come on truck. You can do it this time. I believe in you, truck. ETK. And some of you can lost this innovation. Let's try that again. Come on, truck. That's right. Good truck. There we go. Nice bit of speed up there. Oh, wonders. Unless it's sloping, it should do fine. I'm doing a little bit of rocky stuff, it should do this. Yes. And I believe you should start going down now. I believe that's pretty much the end of the mud track. And I can't see anything. I don't know how tall this track is. I'm going to switch to interior. This will be better for this area. So I was doing it before with the orbital camera. And you couldn't see anything. Due to the position of the trees and of the how tall the vehicle is. So we're gonna go down in this camera. Brakes are full on. I am literally holding the brakes down so hard. I didn't flip last time. And I don't have a clue where we're going. I went past it all pulled, didn't I? There we go. Last time I made it down fine, so I'm going to still count that as a success. Yes, the truck can do it, obviously didn't catch it on camera last time. Damaged our back box thing a little there. Nothing too bad, we set that. But as you see, you can do it with quite a few different vehicles. I don't think there's anything else on this map. I will check the footage actually because I haven't really explored it too much. I've only done these few challenges, as you can see, what I've just done. They should do this pretty easily as well, I'd imagine. As you probably won't do. But we'll give it a go. Come on, track, you can do it. Don't show me up now. There we go. Good, there we go. Perfect. Perfect. Bouncing over them pretty easily, but it will do it. And we lost a fuel tank again. Oh, we've lost it apparently, but it's still on the truck. Luckily it's not exploded on us. It wouldn't be very good if it did. So as you see, you can do this course in both ways. Especially in this one. That one, you're meant to do the same route. But you can do it, or that one at least, in both ways. No point going over there really, it's not really that interesting for me particularly. I was jetting something a bit harder. So it's something else here. What looks like to be a banked circuit type of thing. So we're gonna drive along there. Just like that. Not sure what. Obviously, just trying to get around the corner, isn't it, really? This does look like the top of army training ground, really, doesn't it? It's pretty decent. Or would it be in the back? Wouldn't it seem bouncing around like it's doing? Wouldn't it be a very comfortable ride at all? We're gonna go from the side as well. Bounce around a little bit. I don't know what it's really, because I'm mirrored. Like, you know what that means. It looks like the same banked like thing as each side of these little lumps in the middle. Mounds. And we broke a dry shaft apparently. A little bump broke this dry shaft. That's how indestructible this vehicle is. A mound broke the drive shaft. Oh, rough back bouncing around in it quite a bit. We'll go down this little move one here and pop up again. And I'm gonna jump over here, if you can call it jumping, into the ditch. Now I believe that's everything on the map done, really, isn't it? You've got a bit of tarmac then, which won't be much of a challenge for any vehicle, particularly. Had a little play on that. After we've done that in the beginning. How deep is that? Yeah, quite deep. Done on that. Done often that main one along there. That wouldn't be a problem for any vehicle, like I said. And after we've done that big track at the back. Yeah, it's looking pretty decent map actually. I did enjoy this map. One thing I'm gonna quickly do is see how far I can push the wrong button again. See how far I can drive. Don't know where I am now. I'm lost. I have no idea where I am. Oops. I think I broke my game. I was gonna see how deep that was, so obviously I'm not gonna do that anymore. Probably reload it in the game later on and try again later on anyway. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video on the tough track map. I really enjoyed the map. I do recommend playing it. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, and if they haven't, please get your friends to do the same thing and subscribe as well. Anyway, this has been HG9OU. I hope you enjoyed my video, and please come back for some more BeamNG.drive videos later on.